There are three concepts that you have to follow and three objectives you have to achieve every time you proctor an exam. You have to see the student, you have to see what they're doing, and you have to know who they are. That's the same thing they do in a classroom, and that's the exact same thing we're going to do online.
So how do you do that? It sounds like fairly intense.
Sorry, go ahead, Spencer. What was that?
It sounds as though that might be fairly people intense, labor intensive.
It can be, but we have a system worked out where students can work with a proctor. They only see one proctor, but our proctors can work with about 4 to 6 people at a time. They can manage that and be able to look. So we have a live person that's interacting with them over the webcam. We have them do a slow, careful pan around their surroundings with the camera and then a pan of their workstation area just to make sure they don't have any phones out, any papers out. We want to get a sense of where they are. And then we're going to very closely monitor their face, where their attention is and exactly what it is that they're looking at.
So do you need an ID, like a driver's license or something like that?
Right. So and that's the third step, right? So you're going to hold that up. Perfect. And hold it a little closer to the camera.
Here's my ID.
There we go. Okay. Straighten it up for me there a little bit. Very good. You're going to get 4 questions, and I just need you to answer them as best you can, Spencer.
All right. So,
okay.
Which name is listed as a secondary owner of your residence? Okay. She would resent being called secondary. Which of the following telephone numbers have you ever been associated with? I don't think any of those.
Okay. Okay, scroll down. Prior zip code?
Prior zip code. Oh, my God.
Just do the best you can.
Okay.
Okay. All right, there you go. So the answer was none of the above on several of them. So you got 3 out of 4. That's passing for us.
Okay. So now you authenticated who I am. Now, how do you know I'm not going to cheat on the exam? You're going to watch me the whole time?
Well, how do we know we're not going to cheat on the exam? We're going to watch you the whole time. We have you on the camera, and we can also see your computer screen.
You know, the world is full of hackers. Is there a way that people can get into this system and figure out a way to get around it and cheat?
Absolutely. Well, everybody tries to do that, and we have people attempt to do that every single day. Nothing is ever going to be cheat-proof, right? Even the classroom is not cheat-proof. And that's something that's very important for people to remember. The old way that everyone finds very comfortable in a classroom or in an auditorium, that's not cheat-proof either. That's where cheating was invented. And so we don't have to be absolutely cheat-proof in order for this to be a proper way to take an examination. What we have to be able to do is make it very, very difficult to cheat and then be flexible enough that if we are told ahead of time that someone's going to try something or we detect that someone is trying to do something, that we can react and stop it. The idea with ProctorU and with what Coursera is trying to do here is not to catch cheating, but to prevent cheating.
Answer this if you can. There is a course on Coursera that has 170,000 students taking the course. Now, they all aren't going to finish it, but still, if you have 50 or 60,000 students taking a course, how can you possibly proctor that many students?
It's great to be creating jobs in this economy, isn't it? we are very fastly growing. We doubled in size this year. We expect to at least double in size again next year. And we're opening our 3rd office in Sacramento in March and should be offering our 4th one in the fall. So we're very excited about the growth of this company.